Hello friends, good morning. I hope you all are safe at your home with your parents. And in previous lecture we have learned about some basic definition as well as some basic concepts of the shear transfer. And now we are going to start the procedure for the transfer of the physical shear instead of the demat shear. And in this video lecture we are going to learn about this procedure. So let us start with this procedure. The procedure for the transfer is different for the physical shear and demat shear. See, the procedure for the demat shear transfer and physical shear transfer are quite different. The shear transfer procedure for a physical shear is as under. See, here the procedure for the physical shear transfer is given. Company may refuse to transfer the share if the procedure is not followed satisfactorily. See, here company can refuse to transfer the shares if the procedure of the physical share should not be followed satisfactorily. At that time, company can refuse to transfer the share. First one is the share transfer form. To transfer the share, a prescribed form has to be filled up properly. See, first of all, you have to fill the form properly. Without it is properly filled, it cannot be transferred or it cannot be applied. This form contains complete details of the seller and the purchaser, like name, address and signature. See, form contains all the necessary details like seller, basic details of the seller as well as the purchaser, and the basic details are like name, address and signature. These things are very necessary. Such forms are usually available at the company registered office, authorized share broker and share market, etc. See, these kind of forms can be available at the company's registered office as well as the authorized office or authorized share broker or share market, etc. Without it cannot be transferred fully. Now next one is the share certificate. Share certificate or share allotment letter is to be enclosed along with share transfer form. See, while you are applying for the share transfer procedure, at that time share certificate as well as share allotment letter should be attached while the application is to be given for the company for the transfer of the share. At that time, either if you have a share certificate, then you have to attach the share certificate. If share certificate is not allotted to you, at that time you have to completely attach the share allotment letter with the share transfer application. Next one is the unpaid call. There should be no unpaid call on share that are to be transferred. See, while you are applying for the transfer of share, at that time it is necessary that not a single rupee should be unpaid towards the share, which are very important thing while you are transferring the share. Next one is the objection application. There should be no objection by anybody for the restricting transfer of the share. If you are applying for the transfer of share, at that time it is necessary that nobody should apply for the objection while you are transferring the share. If you are applying for the share transfer form, at that time anyone have objection that we don't let the person to transfer their share, at that time it is not a good sign for you. So it is compulsory that not a single share transfer or objection certificate should be received by the company against your transfer. If any objection is raised by anybody, share transfer will not be granted by the company. See, any kind of objection application may arise, at that time it is compulsory that the company can refuse to transfer the share application. It is a rule of the company. Next one is the satisfactory evidence. If a share transfer form which is duly filled and signed is lost, then application should be made duly signed by both the parties to the company. See, while you have applied for the share transfer, and at that time the share transfer form duly filled and signed are lost, at that time you have to compulsorily made an application against that the our form has been lost and the both the parties have to sign in that particular form, and it is compulsory. Without it is without this type of application it cannot be granted. So it is necessary that you have to compulsorily made an one kind of application that proves that your share application form has been lost. They have to make a satisfactory clarification to the director of the company. See, while you are any kind of clarification should be asked by the director. At that time it is necessary that you have to give a satisfactory clarification for the same, that the our form has been lost. Next one is the lien right. If the company has a lien right on the transfer fee, transfer share can approve transfer to collect its debt. See, if you have any kind of lien on share, at that time it is necessary that the transferee can approve the transfer to collect his debt. First of all, the debt should be collected and then the whole procedure should be going on. Next one is the stamp duty. Proper stamp duty should be affixed on the share transfer form as per the market value of the share. See, proper stamp duty should be affixed, and the share transfer form should be also with the total value of the share. If the stamp duty affixed is as less value, director of company may refuse to transfer the share. If the share application is with the less stamp duty, at that time director can refuse to transfer the share and company cannot transfer this share transfer. Next one is the share certificate to the new shareholder. See, here view shareholder is written, but instead of view it is a new. On approval of the share transfer, the company sends change share certificate to the new shareholder within a 1 month. See, the approval of the share transfer is received, at that time within a 1 month new share certificate should be provided to a particular shareholder who had purchased a share. Next one is the rejection of share transfer. Share transfer can be rejected in case of registrar of the company has put a restriction or court of law has given a verdict of no transfer on those share. See, if any a particular share or any number of share has one kind of verdict against that particular share, that the these shares cannot be transferred at that time. And second one is that the if the registrar of companies has put the restriction, at that time the share transfer cannot be approved and the application should be rejected. Now next one is the provision of the articles of association. For the share transfer, provision of the Companies Act as well as the provision of the articles of association should be followed. While you are applying for the share certificate, at that time the both the rules and regulations, for say for example provision of the Companies Act as well as the provision of the articles of association should be clarified, and it is necessary that the all the restrictions should be followed. If they are not followed, share transfer is not granted. See, all the any kind of rules and regulations should be violated, at that time the transfer cannot be approved. Next one is the register of members. Original shareholder's name is continued up to the completion of the share transfer procedure. See, original shareholder's name should be continue while the share transfer procedure is over. Otherwise, that particular person's name is continue, and after that the new holder's name should be entered. Next one is the right of the dividend. In case of transmission is not completed, expired member or insolvent member is entitled to get the dividend. See, in case of the transmission, at that time, the transmission procedure is not completed, at that time, the expired person's name or insolvent person's name should be continued and they are entitled to get the dividend. See, dead person cannot be available to pick up the dividend, but the relative of that particular person can be received the dividend. Now, in case of a single person company, on the death of the sole member, the person nominated by such member shall be the person recognized by the company as having title to all the share of the member. On the death of the sole member, the person nominated, if any person is nominated, that this person should be available instead of this person's place. At that time, the recognized company have two title for that particular member, that this title has been given to that particular person. The nominee should be informed of such an event by the board of directors of the company. First of all, nominee should be informed by the board of directors, who give the all kind of authorities for the collecting of the shares. Such nominee shall be entitled to same dividend and other rights and liabilities to which such sole members of the company was entitled or liable. Nominee should be entitled and the same dividend and all the rights which are for that particular member has been given to specifically to a particular person. On becoming a member, such nominee can nominate any other person subject to a written consent by that particular person. See, nominee received all rights at that time. It is his or her duty that they have to appoint again a nominee instead of a particular person, that subject to written approval that he or she have no any kind of objection for becoming a member on a same nominee. Next one is the procedure of the physical share transfer. See, now the procedure for the physical share transfer. Share transfer procedure can be divided into two types according to that type of share. First one is the transfer of physical share and transfer of dematerialization of the share. Now the procedure of the physical share transfer. How can be the physical share can be transferred? When shareholder transfer all his shares in favor of another person, then the procedure to be followed is as under. See, while you are transferring the physical share, at that time the procedure should be followed as under. First one is the obtaining the share transfer form. The person who wants to transfer his share has to obtain a transfer form that is known as the transfer instrument, duly signed and selected by the sealed by the company registrar. See, first of all, you have to obtain a transfer form that is known as the transfer instrument and it is sealed by the company's registrar. Next one is the fill up the detail and in the transfer form. In a share transfer form, full details regarding the share buyer and share seller are to be mentioned, such as name, address, name of the share, of the share holding company, market value of the share, share certificate number, etc. After getting that particular form, it is necessary that all the details of the purchaser as well as the seller should be filled very effectively, that is the name, address, name of the shareholding company, market value of the share, share certificate number, etc. details should be filled up very carefully. According to the provisions, necessary stamp duty should be affixed and signed in the presence of the witness. Then it is necessary that the necessary stamp duty should be affixed, and it is signed with in the presence of the witness. The witness has to fill his name, address, and business, etc. also. While the witness is signed, at that time it is necessary that he or she, the person who becomes a witness, or they have to also fill the necessary details like the name, address, and the business, which type of business is to be accomplished by that particular person who became a witness. Next one is the submission of the transfer instrument and share certificate. The purchaser of the share himself or through shareholders delivered the company complete transfer form along with the share certificate to the registered office of the company. The purchaser of the share himself through share broker or any kind of complete transfer procedure, share certificate register should be registered with the registered office of the company. A letter of allotment is enclosed if no share has been issued. See, not a single share is issued. At that time, the share allotment letter should be enclosed with the application. Transfer can also be executed in cases other than a sale. See, the transfer can also be executed in case of other than sales. For example, in case of a gift to someone. See, if you are going to give a share to any person as a gift, at that time you have to compulsorily follow the procedure of the physical share transfer, and it is quite necessary. However, the procedure followed is the same. See, if you give a share to a particular person as a gift, at that time the procedure of the same procedure of the transfer of that particular share is quite simple and quite same as a physical share transfer procedure. Next one is the sending the transfer receipt. On receiving the transfer instrument along with the share certificate, the company secretary issues a receipt for the same. See, while receiving the share application form, share certificate, at that time company secretary issues a receipt for the same, that the transfer instrument is received by the company and it is a perfectly and satisfactorily filled with necessary details. This transfer receipt is the evidence of the submission of the document of the transfer. See, this is a one kind of proof that you have applied for the share transfer, and it is a very useful thing. Now, to inform regarding the transfer by the notice. After receiving the share transfer form and share certificate to the company, verifies transfer instrument and share certificate. See, after receiving the application, company secretary verifies all the details as well as the transfer instrument as well as the share certificate which were enclosed with the transfer application. So it is the responsibility of company secretary that the all details should be verified very carefully, and then after the procedure should be go ahead. After the company informs both the parties through a notice, see, if the verification is successful, at that time it is necessary that the company secretary sends a notice for the same to both the parties. Blank or fraud transfer can be avoided by such a notice. See, fraud and blank transfer, which is illegal, can be restricted by such type of notice. If any party has objection at that time, they ask to inform within 2 weeks. See, If you have any kind of objection at that time, you can ask to the company within 2 weeks, that is of the 14 days. If no objection is received from either party, it is assumed that the transfer is acceptable to both the parties. See, if there is no a single argument or not a single kind of objection at that time, it is assumed that the transfer can be acceptable from the both the parties, and it is a totally true transfer, not a blank or fraud transfer. Now, recording in the share transfer register. After serving notice to both the parties, if no application for an objection has been received from either the transfer or transferor or transferee, then it is assumed that there is a consent of both the parties and the transfer is registered by the secretary in the share transfer register. See, after serving the notice, see, both the parties has been given a particular notice and no a single objection received at that time, transferor or transferee, see, both the parties means transferor as well as the transferee should not apply for any kind of objection. At that time, it is assumed that the consent of both the parties has been received and this transfer is totally true and the further procedure should be taken under the execution. So, the transfer can be approved and the company secretary registered in the share transfer register that the that particular person's share now is going to transfer to such a person by such name. So, the whole procedure can be conducted. The name of the transferee is entered into the share transfer register. See, the transferee's name is entered in the share transfer register that this person is now going to become a member of the company. Next one is the resolution for approval of share transfer. After receiving the share transfer application, a meeting of board of directors is convened by the secretary in which discussion are made regarding the application received for the transfer of share. See, after receiving the application, giving a notice, after take a duration of the 2 weeks, then after not a single application or not a single objection application is received, at that time, company register as well as the company secretary convened a board of directors meeting in which the discussion for the transfer is going on, and after completion of the discussion a particular decision has been taken regarding the receiving of the transfer of share. In this meeting, resolution is passed approving the transfer of share which are sanctioned. See, in the meeting, after discussion, the resolution should be passed for the approving of the transfer of share that this type of application and this type of share is now going to transfer in such a person's name who had applied for the purchasing a share and who has applied for the selling of share. Now the removal of that particular person's name who had sold the share and the person's name who had purchased is entered as in a register of members that now he is a new member of the company. Entering in the register of members, after passing the resolution of transfer of share, the names of the transferor is deleted from the register of member and that of the transferee is added. See, the resolution has been passed, the sanction of approval share transfer is convened. At that time, the person who is a transferor is the person who had sale his share is deleted. Transferor means a person who sells the share, and the transferee means a person who receives the share, or you can say who purchased the share. Now the person who has transfer means sell his share is deleted from the register of members, and the person who had purchased the share, that is of the transferee, is added in the register of members. Now sending the share certificate to new shareholder. After passing the resolution of share transfer, the secretary writes the name of the new shareholder on the back of the share certificate and sends the same with the signature of the responsible officer to the new shareholder. See, after passing the resolution, the transfer of the share, the secretary writes the name of the new shareholder. The certificate, the old certificate who is received by a particular member, has been informed by the company and is sent with the and writes the back the name of new person who had purchased the share and sent the same with the signature of the responsible officer to new shareholder, and this share certificate has been given. If share certificate is too old, there is no space to enter the name, the new certificate is prepared and delivered to him. If there is no space in an old certificate, at that time the new share certificate should be informed and new certificate is prepared by a company secretary and delivered to a particular person. So this is the procedure of the transfer of the share. Now the partial transfer of the share. When a shareholder wants to transfer some of his share from his total holding, then he has to split his share. See, say for example, if any person have a 100 share and he wants to sell a 50 share, at that time he can split their share. For the split, shareholder has to send his share to the register of the register office of the company. First of all, the share should be given to the register office of the company. The company secretary splits the share as per the requirement of the shareholder and send it back. See, the company secretary split the share as per the requirement of the shareholder and it given back. After that, the shareholder sells his share according to the requirement as per the above procedure. And now the procedure should be followed as above, which we have learned in detail very carefully, and the whole procedure should be conducted as per the procedure which we have learned. And this is the partial transfer, and now we are going to give a brief introduction of the summary, you can say the summary of the topics which we have learn, that you have to compulsorily see this video very carefully, that it is very important topic as far as your chapter is concerned as well as the examination is concerned. So you all have to see it very carefully up till the end. So many students are found that they are not watching the video very carefully, and it is not a good sign while you are not watching this video very carefully. In today's video lecture, we have learned about the procedure of the physical share transfer as well as the procedure of the transfer of the share. So it is the important topic, and it may ask in a 4-mark questions in the board examination is concerned. So you have to be careful while writing this type of application and this type of procedure, and you have to be ready with the all necessary details. So I request you all to kindly watch it very carefully and up till the end of the video, not by a few seconds or few minutes because it is harmful for your examination is concerned. So I request you all to watch it very carefully. Thank you. Thank you very much.